Will all AFFFs be banned soon? In this video, I'm looking into the future of fluorine-based foam concentrates. Despite the restrictions on PFOS and PFOA, AFFF still exists. Precursor compounds of PFHxA have been used since the ban on PFOS. So how likely is it that these fluorine-based foaming agents will be banned as well? Before we start, you need to know that I'm mostly talking about the situation in the European Union. But because some of it has roots in international agreements like the Stockholm Convention, and because there's a broad international consensus on the restriction of PFAS, it might also be true for some other countries outside the EU. And keep in mind, I'm talking about the likely future. Of course, I don't know the development for sure. But based on facts, I would like to give an assessment so that you can prepare. In my view, there are three signs for a future ban on fluorine-based foam concentrates. First, there's an international consensus for a restriction. At international conferences where the restrictions of PFAS are discussed, there's a large majority of countries calling for a ban on these substances in foam concentrates. Even China, which until 2019 was still producing PFOS-based foams, agrees to this position in general. The only ones fighting on the front line for the preservation of AFFFs are the lobbyists for the fluorosurfactant manufacturers. Second, there are plans for a ban. There are basically two mechanisms by which components of foam concentrates can be banned. Within the European Union, substances can be regulated under the REACH regulation. And there's also the International Stockholm Convention on persistent organic pollutants. If there's an agreement on restriction, this will be included in an EU regulation, and then it usually also affects foam concentrates. The European Union or its member states currently have three initiatives that affect foam concentrates. There is a proposal to restrict PFHxA under REACH, there is a plan to restrict all PFAS in foams in the EU, and there is an initiative for a comprehensive regulation of all PFAS in the EU in general. And future bans coming from the Stockholm Convention can also affect firefighting foams. It is simply unlikely that these initiatives will all pass us by. And the third sign why a future ban on fluorine-based foam concentrates is likely: more and more firefighters are using fluorine-free foam. Here are the results of a survey that we carried out in summer 2020 among the industrial fire departments in Germany. Grouped into industries, you can see the current situation and the development if we include the planning for the next 2 years. Red means that only fluorine-containing foam is used. Yellow means the use of fluorine-containing and fluorine-free foam, and green that only fluorine-free foam concentrate is used. The trend is obvious, except for the situation at the refineries. They have to deal with tank fires, which is the most challenging application for foam. For these three reasons: there's an international consensus for a ban, there are plans for regulations, and fire departments are already transitioning. I am sure that we will see further regulations. So, if a ban is likely, when will it come and will there be exceptions? Here we should look at a report published in 2020 on behalf of the European Commission and the European Chemicals Agency ECHA. It includes the opinions of industry representatives, foam concentrate manufacturers, as well as firefighters. I will include a link in the description. In summary, the report recommends the restriction of PFAS in foam concentrates. But it also differentiates between various fields of applications, such as municipal fire brigades, the military, the chemical and petrochemical industry, or even training with foam. For these fields of application, the report also considers the effect on fire protection if fluorinated foams are banned. Tank fires are considered as the most critical scenario. It is also proposed to use different transition periods for different fields of application. They range from 3 to 10 years, although there is no transition time for training and testing with fluorinated foams. A few years will pass before we will see corresponding regulation within the European Union. It can therefore be assumed that the transition will take place within the next 3 to 15 years and that there will be different exemptions for different applications. The longest transition period will only be for a few scenarios like tank fires. So, will all AFFFs be banned soon? Maybe not soon, and there will be exemptions and transition periods. But in the long term, I'm pretty sure that we will see extensive restrictions of AFFFs.